Hi, my name is Amit Banerjee. I'm a program manager with the SQL Server product group. I'm responsible for the SQL Server database engine running outside of Azure. In the last episode, we talked about how the SQL Server high availability and disaster recovery benefits helps reduce your cost of ownership for running SQL Server architectures outside of Azure. Let's talk today about how you can actually leverage Azure as a disaster recovery site. So we talked about your software assurance giving you a disaster recovery benefit if your SQL Server instance was running on an Azure virtual machine. So let's go and see how this can actually help you deploy interesting patterns where Azure acts as your DR site. So again, I'm going to use a right-aligned architecture just to draw up your instances over here. So let's say you have a architecture where your primary is sitting with 64 cores on an on-premises environment. Your secondary is also having 64 cores each. Now, in this case, the third replica is actually sitting on an Azure virtual machine with 64 cores. As long as you have software assurance covering the primary, the number of cores that you need to license for would be 64 for your primary, none for your secondary. If this is a DR replica on-premises, again, none for that. And if this is serving as a DR replica, you would, again, not need to license it. The operations allowed on the passive replicas are you can do backups, you can do things like maintenance, you can perform DR tests on those environments, and you can actually let monitoring applications connect to it. Now, in this scenario, the architecture now would become pretty simple, where you have, let's say, a data center residing on-prem, and you use Azure as your DR site. So if you have this architecture where you have a primary replica utilizing, let's say, a secondary, and let's assume that we are using always-on availability groups here, you have a secondary which is used for HA and a secondary which is used for DR. Now, your Azure replica could also be using another secondary, which is using this environment as a completely DR site. So essentially, you have a separate data center. Think of Azure as an extension of your data center, and you have a SQL Server instance using a DR VM as a DR for this primary SQL Server instance residing in your data center. In this case, the number of licenses, as long as this is covered by software assurance cores, the number of licenses that you would need for these environments would be zero. Now, you could actually use anything like always-on availability groups. You could use log shipping. You could use a combination of an automated backup and restore to leverage Azure as the VM for your DR site very easily. And the way you do that is if you go into the Azure portal, you will have an option to start creating a VM. Now, when you create a VM, there will be an option where you need to indicate that the SQL Server VM inside Azure, when you're creating the SQL virtual machine, you are going to use it for DR. There's a toggle that allows you to choose DR as the scenario. And once you select this, your license for the SQL Server cores or the SQL IP would not be charged because you're indicating that you have the requisite number of cores running in the data center for the primary where this VM is acting as the DR. So in this scenario, this VM, you would pay for the infra cost, which means you're paying for compute, you're paying for storage, you're paying for your networking. But you're not paying for the SQL Server licenses on this particular virtual machine. And these cores have to be lesser than or equal to the cores running on the primary. This actually gives you a very interesting scenario where you can actually use SQL Server DR sitting on Azure, and this can serve as a site where you actually do DR drills. And if you have any kind of scenarios where you actually had user errors where you needed to do any kind of data recovery, you could actually use this DR site to keep a hot restored environment, hot, warm, standby, without incurring additional licensing costs for SQL Server. This is how you can actually use SQL Server using Azure and reduce your cost of ownership for DR environments, and also be prepared to recover when times of disaster happen, not just physical disaster, but even scenarios where you got deployments wrong and you need to go back to a point in time without having to incur additional storage and compute costs within your data center. Again, we will talk more about a scenario where this entire setup that you see over here, when it runs in Azure, stay tuned for more. Thank you for joining this session.